गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर हेयर विद द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ द चैप्टर फर्स्ट न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट्स एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द हेटरोट्रॉपिक न्यूट्रिशंस। सो बिफोर लर्निंग अबाउट द न्यू टॉपिक्स लेट अस रिकॉल व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड इन द लास्ट प्रीवियस क्लास। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस नो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज फूड। सो फूड इज द सब्सटेंस दैट कैन बी ब्रोकन डाउन into simpler substance in order to produce energy. Second, we discussed that what is the necessities of the food. So food give us energy, food helps in the growth and development of the body, and food also helps in the repairing of the body tissue. The energy provided by us by food to us is used to carry out various activities such as breathing, walking, running, playing and studying, etc. Next, we discuss how we take the food. So the process by which an organism takes in food and uses it to produce energy to carry out daily activities is called a nutrition. So the process by which an organism takes in food and uses it to produce energy to carry out daily activities is called a nutrition. Next, we discussed that what are the types of nutrition. So we discussed that there are two types of nutrition, heterotrophic and autotrophic. So first of all, we will learn about autotrophic. So in autotrophics, the only example was green plant, because only the green plants are able to make their own food through a process of photosynthesis. And the definition was of autotrophic nutrition was the mode of nutrition by which an organism make its own food is called the autotrophic nutrition, and the organisms are called autotrophs. Next, in the process of photosynthesis, we have learned that plant uses the sun energy to convert water and carbon dioxide into carbohydrates, glucose. The glucose produced is converted into starch, which is stored in various of the parts of the plant, and the byproduct is oxygen, which is released in the air. The most important I gave to you in the exercises also, the most important was the equation of this. That the equation was the carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of oxygen and sunlight, and the carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll give rise to starch and oxygen. Next, we discuss about the condition necessary for the photosynthesis. So there were the four conditions which were necessary for the photosynthesis. First of all was the chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the green color pigment found in the leaves of green plant, which is used to trap the light energy. Next was the sunlight. Sunlight is the main source of energy for green plant. Sunlight is trapped by the green plant of chlorophyll of green plant, and this energy is used to convert carbon dioxide and water into carbohydrates. Next, the important thing was air, that is carbon dioxide. The presence of air, or more specifically carbon dioxide, is essential for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide is obtained from the atmosphere through a small openings called stomata, as you can see in this diagrams. Next, the most important thing which is required by the plants for the photosynthesis is water. The water is absorbed by the roots here, and this root here carries the water to the root. Then root carries this water to the stem, and through stem this water is supplied to the various parts of the plant. Now today we will discuss about heterotrophic nutrition. Today we will discuss about heterotrophic nutritions. As we have discussed that only green plant make their own food through a process of photosynthesis. What about the non-green plant? These non-green plant depend on other sources for nutrition. These green plant depend on other sources of nutrition, and the mode of nutrition by which organism depend upon other plants and animal for food is called a heterotrophic nutrition. Again, I'm repeating, the mode of nutrition by which organism depend upon other plant and animal for food is called a heterotrophic nutrition, and such type of organism that show this type of mode of nutrition is called a heterotrophs. Again, organism that shows the this type of mode of nutritions are called heterotroph. Basically, these are classified into four categories. These are parasitic, saprophytic, symbiotic, and insectivorous plant. The plants of these categories are categorized into four types: parasitic, saprophytic, symbiotic, and insectivorous. Now, one by one, we will look towards each. First of all, parasitic plants that absorb food from other green plants are called parasitic plant. The plants from which they obtain food is called the host plant. So the plant which absorbs the food from the other green plants are called the parasitic plants, and the plant from which they obtain their food are called the host plant. Parasitic plants are not green, they are lack chlorophyll. They contain special root which grow on the host plant and absorbs the nutrition from them. Thus, they does not create any damage or kill the host plant, just only they absorb the nutrition from the host plant. Example of the parasitic plants are Cuscata, that is dodder, and Mistletoe. Now we will talk about the saprophytic plant. So saprophytic plants are the plant. Saprophytic plants are the plant that absorbs nutrition from dead or decaying organic matter, and these plants are not green as they lack chlorophyll. They appear non-green and are usually white in color, and they do not have leaves. Some may contain colorful flower. Saprophytic plants usually grow in the places that are rich in dead leaves which are rotting. So they generally grow on the decaying organic matter. The major difference between parasitic and the saprophytic plants, they grow on the living plants, and whereas the saprophytic grow on the dead or decaying organic matter or the dead or decaying organic leaves. We often find saprophytes growing in deep shade of the tropical forest. Saprophytes converts the dead and decaying organic matter into sugar, which they used as a food. Example of these are Indian pipe and coral roots. Okay, now next we will talk about the next category, that is symbiotic plant. The word symbiosis means the types of relation where two or more organisms associate with each other. That is, where two or more organisms depend on each other for their beneficial manner. Plant existing in such relationship are called the symbiotic plant. A plant which depends on each other for their particular benefits are called the symbiotic plants. Now, the relationship is shown is between the leguminous plant, example beans and peas, and the bacterium called the rhizobium. So these are shown between two types of plant. One is leguminous plant, so examples are beans and peas, and next is a bacterium that is called a rhizobium. What does the rhizobium do? Rhizobium present in the roots of the leguminous plant converts nitrogen into nitrogenous compound that can be used by the plants on the other hand, plants provide nutrition to the bacterium. The example of the symbiotic plant can be called as lichen. Now next, we have already listened in the previous classes that are insectivorous plants. Plant that get the food from most by trapping and digesting animals, mainly insect, are called insectivorous plant. What are the insectivorous plant? plants that depends on the insects for their nutritions are called the insectivorous plant. Now, such plants grow in the soil deficient in certain nutrition and especially nitrogen. These plants grow in the areas where there is nitrogen is very less. These plants get the requirement of the other nutrients from the organism which they eat. Okay, now the examples you are very familiar are Venus flytrap, sundew and pitcher plant. Digestive juices are usually present at the bottom of the pitcher plant that digest the trapped insect. To digest this insect, they require digestive juices, and these digestive juices are prepared and stored in their body. Now we will come to our last topic, how nutrients get replenished into the soil. So plant use the mineral nutrition such as nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium present in the soil for growth. As a result, the amount of nutrition in the soil decreases over a period as more and more crops are grown in it. As we do the farming and as we grow the crops, the nutrition is deficient in the soil. So to increase the or to replenish the nutrition in the soil, we add manure, which is a natural compound, or we add fertilizer, which are the chemical compound, to replenish the soil with the nutrition. Now we will look about manure and fertilizer one by one. What is a manure? Manure is a rich source of an organic matter called humus and certain nutrition, whereas fertilizers are the chemical substance which are rich in one or more nutrition. Now next method through which the soil is replenished with nutrition is nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation is a natural method by which soil nitrogen can be replenished with the help of symbiotic relationship between the rhizobium and leguminous plant. Rhizobium converts atmospheric nitrogen which is used by the leguminous plant. Farmer therefore grow plants such as beans and peas alternatively so to replenish the nitrogen in the soil. I think so you may be understanding this. Next, you have to read the chapter once again, and again I will repeat this chapter thoroughly. Okay.